Tigers to come toward this evening's Friars Hall. In this afternoon, Blood Top Tops, Women's Basketball Contest, your Chargers, they know the statesmen of Westville State University. Fans of University of Alabama, Huntsville, the Westside Conference, and the end story.
Welcome in to another broadcast of UAH Basketball. Scott Tyson with you inside Spraggins Hall, and it is a doubleheader night inside because, thank goodness for that, because outside it is wet, it is cold, but inside we have got UAH women's basketball on tap for you coming up at the bottom of the hour at 5:30. And then 25 minutes after that, around 7:30, we will get the UAH men in action. Both teams welcoming Delta State to Spraggins Hall this evening. Been a little bit since these two teams have squared off against each other. Got to go all the way back to December 9th, early on in the conference portion of the season. The UAH Chargers went on the road, and I believe for just the second time in program history, got a win on the road at Delta State. Now, since then, that was the first win for the conference in the conference for the Chargers at the time. Since then, actually, that was their second win. Since then, UAH has picked up three more conference wins. Delta State comes in tonight 8-10 in conference play. The Chargers come in 5-12 overall in Gulf South Conference play, 5-16 overall. Now, last Saturday, UAH traveled to Lee, took on the 21st-ranked team in the country. They gave them a battle, did UAH, but they ultimately come up short, 72-62. If you are head coach Andrea Lemon, you can take a lot of positives out of that game on Saturday at Lee. This Chargers team is playing with a lot of spirit, a lot of toughness, and playing with a lot of pace over the last six or seven games. The tempo has changed a little bit for the UAH Chargers. The keys for tonight for victory, if you are UAH, this is what is going to have to happen if you want to grab a win tonight. One, you're going to have to shoot the ball well. I know that goes without saying, but the Chargers come in just a 57% shooting team from the floor, 38% from behind the arc, and a 38% shooting team, a 28% shooting team from behind the arc. They come in averaging 57 points a game. So that has got to be a plus. We've seen the Chargers shoot the ball well in this building. In fact, you go back a week ago and the Chargers nearly had one at home. Shot the ball almost over 45%. Did UAH. But they will ultimately come up short a week ago here inside this building, inside Spraggins Hall. So we are 3.5 minutes away from getting this one underway between UAH and Delta State. We mentioned three of those keys. We mentioned some of those keys. That would be against West Alabama that the Chargers nearly had. They led for over 3.5 quarters in that ball game. Shot exceptionally well from the floor, limited their turnovers, and had a good night on the glass. Those are the keys for the Chargers. Why do we stress rebounding when it comes to UAH? They come in a minus 2.7 on the glass. Those numbers are near the bottom of the Gulf South Conference. If you're UAH, you have to limit your turnovers. You have to rebound the basketball. UAH coming in as a team, averaging 17 turnovers a game. So taking care of the ball, a priority for UAH. And then getting that ball to go through the cylinder is also a huge key. Delta State comes in, as we mentioned, 8-10 on the season in Gulf South Conference play. Defensively, Delta State really coming along nicely under first-year head coach Tracy Stewart Lang. They're holding their opponents to just 57 points a game, 36% shooting from the floor, and 26% shooting from behind the arc. They come in averaging 55 points a game. Now, neither team has come in shooting the ball very well. Both teams come in, again, shooting 38% from the floor. Delta State, 26% from behind the arc. So both teams struggling from outside. We'll see what happens tonight here inside Spraggins Hall. Your starting lineups come your way in just a minute.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration, we show up.
This is Wes Neighbors talking to Chris Haygood of Bob Wallace Appliance. Chris, what sets you apart from other appliance dealerships?
Wes, these appliances are going into the most used room in your house, your kitchen. The way we have these appliances displayed, it's easy for you to visualize how they'll look in your home. Wes, what sets us apart is the people. They're well-trained. In fact, they live and breathe these appliances. And if you need service, you'll really appreciate our parts department.
Contact Bob Wallace Appliance at 256-533-2121.
What's better than Valley Equipment Rental? Two Valley Equipment Rentals, and that's just what we have now. The original on the South Memorial Parkway between Drake and Airport Road, and their second location on North Memorial Parkway, just north of Winchester Road. Valley Equipment is locally owned and has more skid steers, excavators, and lifts than anyone in the area, plus all the small tools that you need to get the job done like a pro. And if you are a pro, you need to check out the new North location now, because Valley Equipment has what you need. Learn more at valleyequipmentrents.com.
You know that there are some words that have really messed up our world. The devil, way back in Genesis, said, "Has God really said?" Unfortunately, we often listen to those words of the devil. We question God's word. We often doubt God's goodness, and we make a mess for ourselves and so many others. Hey, let's honor the word of God for what it is. It is God's word. Let's follow it and be blessed by it. Hey, I'm John Dees, pastor of Cross Point Church, smack dab across the street from the YMCA in Madison, and check us out at cpcfamily.org.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
All right, we're going to pause one more minute for our national anthem.
Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance, located in the Rosie's Shopping Plaza, strives to help customers find the best auto insurance, home insurance, life insurance, and more. No matter where you are in life, Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is here to help you find your best insurance and retirement needs. You can find them on the web at brianbellamyagency.com or call them at 256-539-7530. Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is a proud supporter of UAH Athletics and reminds everyone to go Chargers. Brian Bellamy State Farm, here to help life go right.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
The UAH Pep Band on hand tonight inside Spraggins Hall as we've got UAH women's basketball for you on 97.7 ESPN The Zone 3 and accompanied by video here on the UAH Charger YouTube page. So welcome in to a Thursday night inside Spraggins Hall. The Chargers getting ready to take on Delta State and the starting lineups being introduced at this time. We run those starting lineups down first for Delta State. Jenny Higginbotham getting the start for Delta State. Higginbotham, a freshman out of Hot Springs, Arkansas. Number 11, Michelle Smith getting the start for Delta State as well. A junior out of Marietta, Georgia. Number 12, Cameron Davis, a graduate student from Monticello, Mississippi.
Remember back in the day when you taught me to live and I taught you to pray. We went in the battle together, no matter the weather, we never delayed. You gave me commands, I always obeyed. I never let you go astray. I never thought I'd see the day that you would come and just betray me. Sick of playing silly games, you never loved me anyway. You should not have let me get away, cause now I'm hunting for my prey. I'm bigger, I'm better, my mind is a weapon. I won't ever let up, you try to break me down and I'ma just get up. They ask me how I did it, I'ma just tell them I rose up. I'm a survivor. Fight for my life. Coming back stronger. I will arrive. I'm a survivor. Fight for my life.
15, Andy Flackard, the talented freshman from Ridgeland, Mississippi. Getting the start tonight as well, along with number 20, Bella Matchin, the sophomore from Morris, Alabama. Number 24, Maddie Krieger, the freshman from Rogersville in the starting lineup. And rounding out the starting five for the home team, number 45, Haley Nichols, the talented freshman from Avon, Indiana, getting the start tonight. So those are the five starting for UAH as we are getting ready for another busy night of Gulf South Conference basketball right here on 97.7 ESPN The Zone. Chargers again coming in 5-12 in Gulf South Conference play. Delta State entering the night 8-10 in conference play. And will be Grace Watson in the circle for Delta State. Again, Grace prepping up at the road here right up 431 at Hazel Green High School. Haley Nichols will be in the circle for UAH. 10 minutes on the clock. We are just about ready for UAH Charger basketball. Let's see if the Chargers can heat up the night here inside Spraggins Hall. It's 40 degrees outside. Chargers need it to be a little bit warmer here inside tonight. The referee giving us the sign we are ready for basketball. Ball's in the air, and we are underway inside Spraggins Hall. Delta State controls the tip. That's going to be Elena Smith getting the ball over to the left side to Cameron Davis. Trying to find the ball down low. Get the ball down low. Michelle Smith kicks it out to the left corner. 15 on the shot clock. Over to Grace Watson. Watson kicking it down inside the paint to Cameron Davis. No good. Ball free. Andy Flackard comes away with it. Pushing the tempo is Flackard. gets UAH into their offense. Haley Nichols, top of the key, thought about the three, now trying to find somewhere to go. Bella Matchin will drive, little six-foot jumper off the rim, no good. Delta State comes away with the board, and the Devils pushing the tempo. The three from the corner from Michelle Smith is off the mark. UAH comes away with the rebound. That's going to be Maddie Krieger hauling it in. Krieger wasting no time getting the Chargers into their offense. Over to Flackguard. Over to Adel on the far right side. Flackguard, the three, no good. Grace Watson controls the rebound. Here comes Delta State. We are scoreless, each team with two possessions so far. No one has found the scoreboards yet. Davis along that far side gives it over to Higginbotham. 14 on the shot clock. Down low to Watson. Watson working on Nichols. No good. Haley Nichols comes away with the rebound. Krieger across the timeline. Krieger gives it over to Adel. Adel finds some room, and she's going to be fouled. No basket. So we've got our first foul of the night. That's going to belong to Elena Smith, her first, of course, the team's first. So UAH to inbound it underneath their own basket. 22 on the shot clock. Gives it out to Flackguard. Into the corner. The three off the mark there from Matchin. And the Chargers still scoreless. We have played nearly 2 minutes. Neither team has been able to find the scoreboard. Chargers, though, with 20 on the shot clock. The inbound underneath the basket over to Flackguard. Flackguard gives it over to Matchin. Down to Adel on the left side. The beautiful pass down low to Andy Flackguard, and the Chargers are on the board. Beautiful pass from Matchin to Flackguard, and just like that, Chargers on top, 2-0. Davis now for Delta State. Gives it over to Smith. 14 on the shot clock. Smith being guarded by Flackguard. Smith goes one-on-one, kicks it over to Watson. Watson being pressured by Nichols. 4 on the shot clock. The 12-foot jumper, no good. But Delta State comes away with the offensive rebound, and they will maintain possession. We mentioned in the pregame that UAH needs to control the glass, cannot let Delta State have too many second-chance opportunities. The inbound pass to Watson. Gives it over to Smith. The three ball in the corner from Higginbotham, well off the mark, and the battle for the rebound goes UAH's way. So with 7:26 left to go in the first quarter, both teams finding points hard to come by. UAH on top, 2-0 though. Adel gives it over to Matchin. Matchin to the far side. Down to Krieger, down low to Nichols. She draws a double team. Haley nowhere to go with it. Gives it back over to Matchin with 15 on the shot clock. 12 on the shot clock. Gives it over to Krieger. 8 on the shot clock. Maddie Krieger's going to have to try to make something happen. 4 on the shot clock. Krieger, the reverse layup, gets it to go somehow. Maddie Krieger, the up and under, gets it to go. And the Chargers are up 4-0. Back comes Delta State. Watson working on Nichols. The little dish off the mark from Cameron Davis. Davis too strong off the glass. Delta State can't find a bucket early. Haley Nichols will try for three. You betcha! Haley Nichols! She gets the triple. Chargers on top 7-0. And Delta State wants a early timeout.
Qualis Corporation, headquartered here in Huntsville, is a woman-owned small business providing technical services in the areas of engineering analysis, testing, and support services to both commercial and government customers. For 29 years, Qualis employees have provided award-winning support to complex technical and engineering efforts, helping ensure critical programs, products, and systems are acquired, tested, and fully operational when fielded. Qualis Corporation, proud sponsor of the UAH Chargers. Go Chargers!
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
And welcome back to Spraggins Hall. Scott Tyson with you here on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone 3. And, of course, UAH's YouTube channel. It is UAH Women's Basketball. Delta State in town tonight. Double hitter. Don't forget the men following this game. With 6:32 left to go in the first, the Chargers on top, 7-0. Chargers 3 of 6 from the field, 50% so far, 1 of 3 from behind the arc. Delta State 0 of 6 to start the game. So UAH defensively doing a good job. Delta State, though, on the inbounds. Nowhere to go. Delta State kicks it down low. Watson makes a move off the glass. Good. So Grace Watson gets Delta State on the board. The Statesman now trails 7-2. Back comes UAH. Krieger gives it over to Flackguard on the far right side. Flackguard goes to work. Gives it over to Krieger. Down low to Haley Nichols. Nichols draws a double team. Adel back over to Nichols. 10 on the shot clock. Krieger gives it over to Flackguard. 6, 5, 4, 3. Flackguard, the long three, you betcha! With the shot clock running out, Andy Flackguard with the triple, and it's a 10-2 ball game. Chargers up by 8. Here back comes Delta State. Smith gives it down low to Watson. Watson, the backdoor pass is good to Elena Smith. So it's a 10-4 ball game now, favor of UAH. Matching, trying to get it down low to Nichols, and we've got a kick ball. Ball goes out of bounds. UAH retains possession, 20 on the shot clock. Krieger to inbound it. Gives it over to Flackguard. Flackguard directing the offense, far right side to Adel. Back over to Matchin. Matchin trying to make something happen. Gets it into the lane. The little jumper, no good, off the mark. And Smith comes away with a rebound. Across the timeline comes Delta State. Michelle Smith trying to go to work on Andy Flackguard, but picks up her dribble. Gives it back over to Elena Smith. She directs traffic, being guarded by Maddie Krieger. Chargers in a man-to-man defense. Cameron Davis now trying to go to work against Adel. 7 on the shot clock, and we've got a travel. That is a turnover back to UAH. So the Chargers have a chance to add to their 6-point lead, up early 10-4. 4 minutes and 35 seconds left to go here in the first quarter. Flackguard gives it up to Krieger. Over to Adel, back over. Down low to Haley Nichols. Nichols tried to give it back to Matchin, but the ball's taken away by Michelle Smith. The three ball from Jenny Higginbotham rattles in. So that cuts the lead to 3. UAH now up 10-7 on Delta State. Chargers need a field goal here. Haley Nichols kicks it over to Krieger. Krieger in the corner for 3. Yes, and she fouled. You betcha. Maddie Krieger, the 3-ball. She'll head to the free throw line for a chance for a 4-point play. We mentioned the Chargers needed a basket, and they get one in a big way. Maddie Krieger's first 3 of the night. She's got 5 early points, has a chance to make it 6 right here. Free throw is up and good for Maddie Krieger. She's got the triple. She's got the field goal, the 3-point, and the free throw here in the first. Chargers lead by 7 with 3:50 to go. Delta Straight now trying to answer. That's going to be Michelle Smith on that far side. Gives it over to Grace Watson. Watson gives it back to Smith. Smith, the little jumper, no good. The fight for the rebound goes to Andy Flackguard. Flackguard pushing the tempo across the timeline. Gives it over to Adel. Adel makes the move. The little jumper off the mark. Nice little move there Here comes Delta State. Now we're picking up the tempo. Watson thought about it, drives the lane. Grace Watson well off the mark. And we've got the rebound for UAH. Krieger takes it up, the little five-foot jumper. No good for Maddie Krieger. And Delta State pulls down the defensive rebounds. Tracy Stewart Lang, the head coach of Delta State, just saying slow the pace down a little bit. Elena Smith dribbles it into the far corner, makes a move, drives baseline. Good for Elena Smith, and she will head to the free throw line. Foul is going to be called on Maddie Krieger. That is her first, team's first here in the first quarter. So far, the Chargers shooting 45% from the floor, 60% from behind the arc. Delta State, we mentioned they were 0-for-6 to start the game. Since then, they are now 4 of their last 6. So Delta State starting to heat up. But Elena Smith misses the free throw. She was an 83% free throw shooter, and she missed that one. But the Chargers turn the ball over. Delta State has a chance to cut in to this five-point deficit. It's Mackenzie Hill now along the right side. Hill drives, gets into the lane, has her shot blocked by Elise Hughes, but Hughes got a little too much of the body. And that is going to be Elise Hughes' first personal. Charger second of the night, but that is going to send Mackenzie Hill to the free throw line for the first time. Mackenzie Hill, a 68% free throw shooter on the season. Takaya Tony checks in for the first time for Delta State. First one is up and rattles out. So as a team, Delta State shooting 71% from the free throw line. They are 0-of-2 to start the game. Second one is up and good for Mackenzie Hill. So it's a 14-10 ball game. Chargers up by 4 with 2:25 left to go in the first. Krieger gives it down low to Elise Hughes, and Hughes going to be held. Brisa Maxwell picks up her first. That is the third team foul for Delta State. So two more, and the Chargers will head to the free throw line. The inbound pass to Flackguard. With 18 on the shot clock, Flackguard pulls it out, resets the offense. Olivia Howard's in the game now for the first time. Flackguard for three off the mark, and Delta State pulls down the rebound. Pushing the tempo is the Statesman. Michelle Smith gives it over to Brisa Maxwell. Back over to Andrea Duran, who's checked in for the first time for Delta State. Back over to the far left side. Ball's going to end up in Maxwell's hands. That's going to be Hill drives. And is that on? That is going to be on Mackenzie Hill. That is her first, fourth team foul now for Delta State.
Coming in for Delta State is number 13, that is Chanel Kitchen.
So the Chargers enjoying still a four-point lead, 14-10 with 1:45 left to go here in the first quarter. Is it over to Elena Taylor, who is in now in for the ball game for the first time, and Taylor lets the three go. You betcha! Elena Taylor's first shot is a triple, and it is good. Chargers push the lead back up to 7. Here comes Delta State. Is it over to Hill? Back over to Chanel Kitchens, who's in now for the first time. Andrea Duran, nowhere to go, being guarded by Olivia Howard. Statesman get it down low to Dekaya Tony off the mark. And Maddie Krieger comes away with the rebounds. Krieger gets the Chargers into their offense. Gives it up over to Andy Flackguard to the right side to Hughes. Hughes has a wide open lane, kicks it out for the three ball for Krieger. You betcha! Oh, her foot is on the line. They say Maddie Krieger's foot was on the line. That was a 2, not a 3. But still, the Chargers push the lead to 9, 19-10 with 45 seconds left to go in the first. So Delta State taking their time. That's going to be Andrea Duran, and the pass goes off the mark from Duran, out of bounds. That is a turnover. Ball goes back to UAH. That is the fourth turnover here in the first quarter for the UAH, for Delta State, I should say. Chargers with just two turnovers early. Two turnovers. So Andy Flackgard, about a two-second difference between the game clock and shot clock. Flackgard with 10 on the shot clock, gives it over to Hughes. To Howard with 7. Elena Taylor trying to make something happen. Krieger drives baseline, 3 on the shot clock. Howard has to let it go. No good. The rebound from Flackgard's no good. But what a first quarter it is for the UAH Chargers. So after our first 10 minutes, it is UAH 19, Delta State 10. More UAH Charger basketball right after this.
Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance, located in the Rosie's Shopping Plaza, strives to help customers find the best auto insurance, home insurance, life insurance, and more. No matter where you are in life, Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is here to help you find your best insurance and retirement needs. You can find them on the web at brianbellamyagency.com or call them at 256-539-7530. Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is a proud supporter of UAH Athletics and reminds everyone to go Chargers. Brian Bellamy State Farm, here to help life go right.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
And welcome back to Spraggins Hall. It is UAH women's basketball. Gulf South Conference action on a Thursday. Chargers playing host to Delta State, and we have one quarter in the books. Chargers. So they just made the announcement that Maddie Krieger's basket was indeed a 2, not a 3. Chargers, though, leading 19-10 after the first 10 minutes. Chargers shooting 46% from the floor in that first quarter, 57 from behind the arc, 4 of 7 and 1 of 1 from the free throw line. Delta State shooting just 30% for the game. And 33% from behind the arc. Chargers have the ball to start the second. Elise Hughes trying to find Haley Nichols down low. She does. Nichols goes to work. The turnaround. Jay, no good. And Delta State comes away with the rebound. Statesman wasting no time getting it up into the front court. Now they settle into their offense. Chargers staying. It kind of looks like into a matchup zone defense. Grace Watson drives baseline, being guarded by Flackgard. Watson, good. Grace. I believe that was Grace Watson on the basket there. They gave it to Cameron Davis, but it was Grace Watson, her second basket of the game. Now Haley Nichols at the free throw line, nowhere to go. She gives it over to Maddie Krieger. Krieger trying to get it down to Elise Hughes, and that's going to be a turnover. And the Statesman pushing the tempo. That's going to be Elena Smith drives, but she is going to be fouled. So the Chargers. Elena Taylor picks up the foul. Her first, team's first here in the second. So Jenny Higginbotham to inbound it. Gives it over to Watson. Watson hands it over to Dekaya Toney. Toney high off the glass. Her first field goal of the night. Now all of a sudden it's just a 5-point Charger lead. Elise Hughes, the little spin off the glass. No good for Elise Hughes. She fouls it up. Her rebound gives it over to Haley Nichols. No good. That ball went halfway down and came out for Haley Nichols. Delta State has a chance to cut into their five-point deficit. 19-14, Chargers enjoying the lead with 8:25 left to go here in the second quarter. Michelle Smith gives it down low to Grace Watson. Watson, the give and go to Dekaya Toney. The three ball is good for Elena Smith. Alana Smith, her first three of the night. And all of a sudden, the Chargers now only up two, 19-17. Delta State nearly the steal right there. So the Chargers have started the second quarter 0-3 from the field. Meanwhile, Delta State has started the second quarter 3-3 from the field. So this is kind of a role reversal from the first quarter. UAH started a little warmer than Delta State. Delta State missed their first six field goals to start the game. The Chargers have missed their first three to start the second quarter. Jesse Jennings now into the ballgame for the first time, and the pass to Haley Nichols goes off the mark, and Delta State the steal, the lay-in from Dekaya Toney. So we are tied at 19. Delta State on a run to start the second. Chargers need a field goal and need one bad. Delta State nearly the turnover, but Jenny Higginbotham going to get called for the foul. That is her second. Team's first here in the second. Chargers 0-3 from the floor still here in the second, looking for their first 2 points of the second quarter. Inbound pass to Andy Flackguard. Flackguard gives it over to Maddie Krieger. Back over to Jesse Jennings. Jennings over to Flackguard. 10 on the shot clock. Chargers need to get into their offense. Flackguard drives, gives it over to Taylor in the corner. Good! Elena Taylor, you betcha! She's got two baskets tonight, both of them three-pointers. And the Chargers now back up 3-22-19. That's going to be a drive from Smith. Back over to Grace Owen. Owen being guarded by Haley Nichols. Kicks it out to Dekaya Toney. Toney's going to drive. Spins on Jesse Jennings. And they're going to get Dekaya Toney for the offensive charge. That is on Dekaya Toney. So Jesse Jennings stands in there and takes the charge. Gives the ball back to the Chargers, who can add to their three-point lead. Flackguard over to Taylor. Taylor has the hot hand from behind the arc today. Taylor going to thought about the three. Now she's going to drive. Nope, she's going to drive. Beautiful move. Elena Taylor, scoop and score. Elena Taylor has eight on the night. Chargers now increase that lead to five. That comes Delta State. Grace Owen being guarded again by Haley Nichols. Nowhere to go for Michelle Smith. Kicks it out to Chanel Kitchens. Gives it over to down low. The beautiful pass to Dekaya Toney. Dekaya Toney has six. And the Chargers now just lead three, 24-21. Krieger over to Jennings. Jennings trying to find Haley Nichols down low, but gives it the backdoor cut to Elena Taylor, and that pass is stolen away. Back comes the Statesman. Michelle Smith gives it down low to Grace Owen. Owen drives on Haley Nichols, kicks it back out to Smith. Smith and Watson playing a little two-man game. Now Dekaya Toney hands it off to Elena. Alana Smith. And I believe they're going to get Chanel Kitchens. Actually, it's going to be on Dekaya Toney. The offensive foul on Dekaya Toney. Her second, she will have to head to the bench. Third team foul for Delta State here in the second. So the Chargers can add to that three-point lead. Andy Flackguard gives it over to Olivia Howard. Howard spins into the baseline. Good for Olivia Howard. Her first field goal of the night gives the Chargers a five-point lead, 26-21. We're at 5 minutes left to go before the half. So Delta State now in no hurry to run their offense. Over to the right side to Michelle Smith. Smith drives it down to the corner, back over to Grace Owen. Owen will drive, kicks it back out to Alana Taylor, or Alana Smith, I should say. And Smith, the basket is good for Alana Smith. That's going to be Halem Adel with the foul, her first, second team foul. And so when we come back, we'll have free throws. Chargers lead 26-23 with 4:44 left to go before the half.
Qualis Corporation, headquartered here in Huntsville, is a woman-owned small business providing technical services in the areas of engineering analysis, testing, and support services to both commercial and government customers. For 29 years, Qualis employees have provided award-winning support to complex technical and engineering efforts, helping ensure critical programs, products, and systems are acquired, tested, and fully operational when fielded. Qualis Corporation, proud sponsor of the UAH Chargers. Go Chargers!
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Welcome back to Spraggins Hall on the campus of UAH. It's UAH Women's Basketball on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone 3, and the UAH YouTube channel. Scott Tyson with you here on a Thursday night. Chargers taking on Delta State. UAH up 26-23 with 4:44 left to go in the second. But Delta State at the free throw line shooting one. And it is up and good for Alana Smith. Her first free throw of the night. She's an 83% free throw shooter. That cuts the deficit to two. Elena Taylor over to Olivia Howard. Back over to Elena Taylor, down low to Adel. Gives it out. A little spin move there from Bella Matchin. Back over to Flatguard. 10 on the shot clock. Flatguard gets the Chargers set. Flatguard drives, kicks it out to Taylor for three. Off the mark. That's Taylor's first miss from behind the arc tonight. Smith pushing the tempo for Delta State. No good. Flatguard comes away with the rebound, and the Chargers on the move. UAH on top, 26-24 with 3:55 left to go before the break. Down low to Olivia Howard. Howard kicks it out to Flatguard. Flatguard drives over to Adel. Adel's going to drive. No good. Back out to Flatguard. Eight on the shot clock. Adel, six on the shot clock. Gives it over to Taylor. Down low to Howard. Three on the shot clock. No good from Olivia Howard. Back comes Delta State. Michelle Smith being guarded by Andy Flatguard along that right side. Gives it over to Smith. Smith going to drive, spins, kicks it back out to Michelle Smith. Gives it back down low to Alana Smith. Actually going to be Cameron Davis, her first field goal of the night. And we are tied once again, this time at 26. Chargers looking to go down low to Andy Flatguard. Pass off the mark, and that is a turnover. That's the sixth turnover for UAH on the night. So far here in the second, Delta State outscoring UAH 16-7. A big reason why we are tied at 26. Chargers would lead 19-10. At the end of the first quarter, but Delta State has gotten hot from the field. They are shooting 87% from the floor here in the second quarter. Chargers just shooting 43%. But that is a turnover. Delta State, their sixth turnover of the night, gives UAH a chance to take the lead back with 2:45 left to go before the break. Krieger gives it over to Adel. Adel drives into the paint, and she would lose the basketball. Andrea Duran takes it across the timeline. Gives it over to Asashi Barrage. Down low to Grace Watson. Watson being guarded by Nichols. Tries to force the pass. Somehow Watson ends back up with it. Off the glass. No good for Grace Watson. And Haley Nichols grabs the rebound. Gives it off to Krieger. Maddie Krieger across the timeline. Gives it over to Haley Nichols for three. You betcha! Haley Nichols has 6 points. Both of them coming from behind the arc. And the Chargers once again have a three-point lead, 29-26. Michelle Smith for Delta State on that far side. The long three is good. Otashe Burridge for three. Her first field goal tonight ties us at 29. Zolaina Taylor gives it over. Back over to Adel. Adel's going to drive baseline. Kicks it out to Krieger. Back over to Taylor. Taylor going to give it over to Matchin. Matchin spins into the lane. The little jumper. Good. That's Bella Matchin. Her first field goal of the night. Chargers back out in front. 31-29. 1:10 left to go before the half. Delta State now content to take their time. Cameron Davis at the free throw line. Little jumper off the glass. No good. And Haley Nichols controls the glass. Maddie Krieger pushing the tempo. Gives it over to Haley Nichols. Haley thought about the three. She's got two already tonight. Krieger, nowhere to go. 18 on the shot clock. Gives it over to Taylor for the long three. High off the glass. No good. And Delta State controls the rebound. So we got 38 seconds left to go before the break, and Delta State trails by two. Chargers up 31-29. Delta State gets it down low, and that's going to be a turnover. Was it tipped? The referee says yes, it was tipped. So 25 on the game clock, 12 on the shot clock for Delta State. Your five on the floor for UAH. Elena Taylor, Bella Matchin, Haley Nichols, Elise Hughes, and Maddie Krieger. Those are your five on the floor for UAH. 10 on the shot clock. Michelle Smith gets into the lane, lays it up, and good. That's too easy for Delta State. Chargers let a wide open lane go there, and then on the inbounds pass, UAH turns it over with 12.8 left. And Delta State wants a 30-second timeout.
What's better than Valley Equipment Rental? Two Valley Equipment Rentals. And that's just what we have now. The original on the South Memorial Parkway between Drake and Airport Road, and their second location on North Memorial Parkway, just north of Winchester Road. Valley Equipment is locally owned and has more skid steers, excavators, and lifts than anyone in the area, plus all the small tools that you need to get the job done like a pro. And if you are a pro, you need to check out the new North location now, because Valley Equipment has what you need. Learn more at valleyequipmentrents.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Welcome back to UAH basketball on the campus of UAH inside Spragans Hall. Scott Tyson with you on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone 3, and of course, the YouTube channel here at UAH. Chargers playing Delta State. 12.8 seconds left to go before the break. UAH and Delta State tied at 31. Don't forget, coming up following this game, we'll have the UAH men taking on Delta State. Steve Moulton and myself will be with you for that one. Delta State to inbound it. And they do. That's going to be Andrea Duran, the three. No good off the mark. And Delta State to retain possession off the miss. 7.5 left to go. Duran to inbound it to the left of her basket. Duran, the long pass out to the top of the key. 5-3-2, and we've got a foul away from the basket. That's not a bad foul for UAH, because it's going to be on Haley Nichols, her first, but it is only the third team foul for UAH. So not a bad foul there if you're Haley Nichols. Now, Coach Andrea Lemon will take out Nichols, so she does not pick up her second before the half. Duran to inbound the basketball with just 2.4 on the clock, and that is going to be an over the back, over and back. The pass goes a little bit too long, and Delta State turns the ball over. Their seventh turnover of the half gives UAH 1.5 to do something. Taylor inbounds it to Krieger. Krieger, the half court. He's good! You betcha! Maddie Krieger! The half court heave gives UAH the halftime lead. 34-31. You betcha, Maddie Krieger. So the Chargers head to the break on top, 34-31.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
And welcome back to Spraggins Hall. We are at halftime of the UAH women's game here on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone 3. Chargers, thanks to a Maddie Krieger half-court heave, enjoy a 34-31 lead at the break. Chargers shooting 48% for the game from the field. How about this? They are 7 of 12 from behind the arc, 88% for the Chargers in the first half. Delta State, 13 of 26 from the floor. They are shooting 50%, 3 of 5 from behind the arc for 60%. Delta State, 2 of 4 from the free throw line. And UAH got to the free throw line one time in the first half, and they are a perfect 1 of 1. We mentioned coming up after this game, we get the UAH men taking on Delta State. Chargers awfully impressive on the road Saturday in a win against Lee. Steve Moulton had a chance to catch up with UAH head coach John Shulman. Here is that conversation.
Coach, that was something there in Cleveland, Tennessee. Congrats on the win, and that was certainly unique.
Well, unique is a word for it, I guess. What a week we had last week. Come off an L at home, disappointing L, and then really sitting CJ out until he can get healthy. Great win against Shorter, and now we're going into our bitter rival who's coming off an L. And what a day it was. It started with Jack Costa calling me at 7 in the morning saying he's got food poisoning, and ended with half our team having the stomach virus or a flu. And now, you know, what we talked about, though, before the game, because I've been involved in a flu game before, there's no asterisk beside that game. If you win it, it doesn't say everybody had the stomach flu. And if you lose it, it's not an excuse everybody had the stomach flu. It's just a game. It's next man up mentality, and you got to figure it out. And what a place to figure it out at Lee on a Saturday afternoon. That was what an environment, jammed environment. We had an unbelievable crowd. They had an unbelievable crowd. They're a game up on us. We have to win the game. And here we are. You know, we're running out for starting lineups, and Dane Harding, and he was one of the healthy ones. Instead of taking a right, going out to the floor, took a left and went outside to do whatever he needed to do outside. But we left, I would say this, we left our mark at Lee University on last Saturday.
So how are we health-wise, Coach?
You know, CJ's still out. Really want to try to get him healthy, instead of just fooling around at about a 5, try to get him up to about a 7 or 8. But everybody else, that was the front end of the virus on Saturday. Most guys were done with it by Monday. Some guys picked it up on Monday. I think we're in pretty good shape. I think we're in pretty good shape right now, health-wise. If any of the guys are sick, they're on the back end of it. And so, you know, we spent some time in the training room this morning getting an IV this morning. But I think we're on the back end of it. So I feel really, I wouldn't say we're at 100%, but I would say we're close to about 90, 95%.
So welcome to February. This is really when you want that engine starting to hum.
And I thought it started humming on Saturday. You know, what a way to kind of finish January and go into February. We got 5 home games. We got 2 on the road. This is when we start playing. You better be happy and hugging. As Charlton Young, my first assistant at Chattanooga, would say, you better be happy and hugging in February. I said, what are you talking about? And very simple. Most teams are done in February. Yeah. You get to the middle of February, most teams are done, tired of each other, tired of playing, tired of the coaches, tired of looking at each other every single day in practice. Well, we're not. And we're happy and hugging right now, and we're in a great frame of mind. And we had a blast Saturday afternoon, just to be honest. We had a blast before the game. And I love where we are mentally. I love our attitude right now. We've had 2 really good days of practice. But, you know, you got other teams that want to play, and you got other teams that, you know, we're not in first right now, so we're a game out. But I like where we are. And here we go. Here we go on this ride of February. And the last 3 years, we've been really good in February. And we've been one of those teams that's been happy and hugging, and we got to continue to do that this year.
Tell me what you've seen. I know Delta State's been struggling lately, but what have you seen from them? They've got a couple of overtime games. They could be really different.
They won like 4 or 5 in a row, and now they've lost 4 in a row. One reason they've lost 4 in a row is Sam Smith's been out.
Yeah.
And you know good and well he'll be playing tonight. It's just, you know, I thought the UAH way was something different. The UAH way is we get everybody's best shot with everybody's best player, and everybody's juiced up to play us. So Cartwright is, you know, to me, one of the best players in the league. You know, he had 45 the other night against CBU. He's a special talent. And the problem is we can help by doubling him. And then you spacing out there with Dietrich, who literally is making 8 threes a game on us. And then you add Sam Smith to that mix if he's healthy, and now you got a double-headed monster inside, and they can really score the ball. They have kind of glossed over their defensive weaknesses by playing a matchup zone the whole time. And so they started playing that matchup when we played them the first time, which was back in 1982, last year, a long time ago. But now they're pretty good at it. And they play a matchup zone that people aren't used to. And we're going to have to move the ball. And are we going to play zone O? Are we going to play man O? Or what are we going to do against it? I think we're going to have to mix that up. But can we guard them? Can we guard them? I think we can rebound the ball tonight. We've come off 2 double-digit wins on the glass. But can we guard them? And they're hard to guard. Why are they hard to guard? It's because we were hard to guard last year. It's not a secret. You put a guy on a block who can score the ball, well, how you going to stop him? All right, well, you got to double him. All right, well, how you going to double him when you got 3 dudes out on the perimeter who can really shoot the ball? And that's what they do, and that's the problems they pose to us, is that they really shoot it and they can really score it inside. So we're going to mix and match defenses, and we're going to be pretty tough tonight.
I kind of realizing that we're coming off of our quote-unquote flu game, this is usually the time where coaches like to tighten up the belts a little bit, shorten up the bench. You tell me, do you think you're comfortable with the rotations, how things are going right now?
Absolutely not. All right, because it's been a wild and crazy journey. You know, I mean, it may be February, but now all of a sudden Hunter Vick it looked like Hunter Vick the other day. And we don't win that game without Hunter Vick. And we don't win that game without Daniel Saylor. And just to be honest, we don't win that game if Matt Thurman doesn't go in and do what he does in the first half. And I don't know. Let's take a poll. We can have a fan poll before the game on who to play tonight. I really don't know, and I say this all the time. You know, it takes a village to raise a child. It takes a village to win a championship. And you know, Hunter Vick was part of that village on Saturday. And, you know, is he healthy? You know, he's getting there. So I shorten our bench? Probably not. You know, without CJ, maybe on the wing we're a little bit limited. But, you know, can Tanner take care of minutes at 2 and 3? Or can Tanner just kind of take care of the minutes at the 3, and then we can kind of move Vic back to a 2, that we were just going to move Vic back to a 2 anyway, and then all of a sudden Costa got sick. You have a plan. We had an amazing plan going into Saturday. Well, that plan was shot once I got a phone call at 7 a.m. from Costell. But that's life. I mean, you know, we all have plans as parents. Well, that changes when they're born. and they go and they go to the left and go, and you wanted them to go right and they went left. You better adjust. It's kind of like team camp. We have team camp in the summer. You're as organized as you can be before the camp starts. And then if you're not flexible when that camp starts, you're not going to have a very good camp. We're going to be organized when that game starts, but we're going to have to be flexible with our bench. And the nice thing is our bench can do it. They're talented, and they're also held accountable every single day by me and our coaching staff, so they're ready to roll.
If there's one starter that the last two games in particular really impressed me on the boards, it's Max, of him attacking the glass.
It's February. It's time. It's hard for those guys. Max has been around for a long time. It's hard for those fifth-year guys, and Max being a sixth-year guy, to kind of go through what we do. And we're pretty plain and simple in practice. We're doing some of the same drills. We don't get bored with the basics. We're doing some of the same drills right now that we did in August. And now Max is in his fifth and sixth year doing that. I think his attention span and his attention to detail now is back, because it's now crunch time. And it's hard in November to be ready to roll for February and March. And so I think, listen, he said after that game, and I know he meant it, "Dad, I think I'd rather beat Lee at Lee than win a national championship." He was pretty focused. And that was pretty important for Max on Saturday. And I know he wants to finish strong, so these games are going to be pretty flipping important to Max. And he does what he does. And so if he's not making shots, he's going to do it on the glass. And he hasn't been great on the glass this year. He's been good the last couple games, and so let's see if we can continue that.
With the team that's struggling, how important is kind of tightening that screws on them the first 4 minutes?
Well, it'd be great, but you know good and well, I'm just telling you,
Dietrich, didn't happen at Lee though.
I mean, Dietrich makes 3 threes in the first 4 minutes, and Aaron Brooks doesn't even play for him, but he'll throw in a couple. You know, it's like they come in here and that basket looks big to them. Yeah. And we talked about it during film. Let's do a great job on Cartwright. Hey, let's do a great job on Dietrich. Let's don't allow him to come in here and get off those threes. But the problem is you're playing that. I remember last year at this game, we tried to dig a little bit on Cartwright. We didn't guard Cartwright, and we didn't guard Dietrich. And so our doubles have to be good. If our double teams are good in the post, then we don't have to worry about Dietrich. That means we can get – listen, we had 7 double team opportunities against Lee. 6 of those, we stole the ball or they turned it over. But Cartwright's a different beast in there, and he's got size, and he can really pass the ball. But I'm just telling you, if we don't double him, he's going to score 40, and I don't know if we can overcome that. That's what makes him a really good team and makes Neighbor a really good basketball coach.
Well, I'm not going to go there, but that 40-point guy is coming up on Saturday. But let's worry about tonight.
Let's focus on Delta, and we'll focus on MC on Saturday. Listen, our team is really good when they get mad. and the redemption tour of last year. We're very competitive guys. So we understand what we got to do tonight, and we understand that we got a team coming in here on Saturday that beat us by 30. Let's focus on tonight, and then I'll talk to you on Saturday. I'll talk to you on Saturday about NC, but let's have a great night tonight.
Best of luck.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
All right, again, coming up after the completion of this women's game, we will have the men's game with Delta State here inside Spraggins Hall. But first things first, that is the UAH women as they enjoy a 34-31 lead over Delta State here at the half. Scott Tyson with you inside Spraggins Hall on the campus of UAH. Here on 97.7 ESPN, the Zone 3, and of course on the UAH YouTube channel, it is UAH basketball. Make sure you download the 97.7 ESPN, the Zone app, so you can have tonight's game with Delta State at the palm of your hands. The Chargers were led by Maddie Krieger in the first half. She had 11 points. Haley Nichols had 6. Haley Nichols, the presence in the paint for the Chargers, but tonight those points have come from behind the arc. Haley Nichols with 6 points, both of those coming from behind the arc. Delta State would be led by number 33, Alana Smith. Alana Smith, 2, 4, 6, 8, 11, 12 for Alana Smith. I have her down as 12. They have her as 10, so we'll have to see about that. Dekaya Toney, 6 points for Delta State in the first half. So we have 10 minutes on the clock. And Delta State with possession of the basketball to start the second half as they trail by 3, 34-31. Michelle Smith gives it over to Grace Watson, who had a quiet first half, and Watson with the travel to start the second half. Watson, of course, played her high school ball, just right up the road here at Hazel Green. Has a nice cheering section on hand, but she only has 4 points in the first half. Maddie Krieger drives, ball goes off the toe of her shoe, out of bounds. That is turnover number 9 for the Chargers. So UAH turns it over on their first possession, cannot add to their 3-point lead. Back comes Delta State. And it's going to be Cameron Davis. Gives it over to Alana Smith. Smith going to drive. Kick it out in the corner for 3 for Michelle Smith. No good. And Michelle Smith stays with the rebound. Delta State with a second possession. Cameron Davis down low being guarded by Maddie Krieger. No good, and Krieger gets the rebound. So back come the Chargers. Their second trip down the floor in the second half. Krieger, the scoop lane off the mark. That one looked like it wanted to go in but did not roll the right way. So back comes the Statesman. Grace Owen, the little jumper. The 12-foot jumper is good for Watson. Her third basket of the night, and the deficit or the lead for the Chargers is 1. How about Krieger drives and Watson with the block there? So the Chargers will inbound it with 20 on the shot clock. Maddie Krieger to the right of her own basket. Chargers enjoying a 1-point lead, 34-30. Krieger nowhere to go, gives it over to Haley Nichols. That's going to be the drive from Bella Matchin, no good. Chargers still without a field goal here to start the second half. So Maddie Krieger once again to inbound the basket ball to the right of her basket again. This time gives it over to Andy Flackard. Flackard directing traffic. Delta State sitting in a 2-3 zone. Gives it over to Matchin. Matchin finds a little soft spot in the zone. No good. Has the shot blocked by Grace Watson. So the Chargers will try again. This time inbounding it again from the right side of their basket. Krieger kicks it out to Adel. Back over to Krieger in that right corner. Five on the shot clock. Adel drives the dish to Flackguard. Flackguard, little jumper, no good. And Grace Watson controls the rebound. Here comes Delta State. They can take their first lead of the night. Kicks it down low. Good for Cameron Davis. Actually, that was Otashe Burridge on the basket. And Delta State has their first lead of the night, 35-34. Flackguard on the right side. Gives it over to Krieger. Krieger in the corner for Adel. Back over to Matchin for three. No, that off the mark, but Haley Nichols gives UAH a second opportunity with the offensive board. Delta State now switching it up, going with a man-to-man defense. The little give-and-go down low is stolen away by Delta State. The Chargers still without a basket to start the second half. Delta State sets it up. That's going to be Alana Smith. Back over to Smith with 16 on the shot clock. Chargers playing a little man-to-man defense. It's going to be Michelle Smith, the floater, no good off the mark, but the tip out goes to Grace Watson and Delta State with another possession. That's going to be Alana Smith, drives on Haley Nichols, and she gets it to go. So the third field goal for Alana Smith gives Delta State a three-point lead, 37-34. Haley Nichols down low. That's good for Haley Nichols. And Haley Nichols will head to the free throw line. So her first two-point field goal of the night for Haley Nichols sends her to the free throw line with a chance to tie. Nichols, an 82% free throw shooter, and the freshman's free throw is good. And we are tied at 37. So that field goal or that free throw from Haley Nichols, just the second free throw of the night for the Chargers. Good news, they've made both of them. So we're tied at 37 with 6:20 left to go in the third. Delta State's basketball. Smith drives, being guarded by Maddie Krieger. Now she drives baseline, no good. And Haley Nichols comes away with the basketball. Chargers can regain the lead. Elena, that's Flackguard. Nichols for three, no good that time. But Flackguard, Andy Flackguard tracks down the loose ball. Elise Hughes over to Maddie Krieger along the right side. Krieger had the hot hand in the first half. That three off the mark there. So Alana Smith being guarded by Elena Taylor. Now down low to Grace Owen, back out to Smith. Delta State content just to take their time offensively. 15 on the shot clock. The give and go down low, no good, is Cameron Davis, and the Chargers come away with the rebound. Nichols over to Elise Hughes. Hughes makes a move, gets into the paint, and Hughes loses the basketball but stays with it, and they're going to call it for a double dribble. That's going to be the 12th turnover on the Chargers tonight. We mentioned coming in as a team, UAH averaging 17 turnovers as a team. Rebounding and turnovers, a huge key for the Chargers to come away with a W tonight. Right now we are tied at 37. Chargers with 11 turnovers in the game. The drive from Michelle Smith, nowhere to go. Going to give it down low to Grace Owen. Owen tried to make a move, but she had nowhere to go. And Haley Nichols comes away with the steal. That is going to be Maddie Krieger drives, nowhere to go. Drives it baseline, comes all the way back out and resets the offense. 15 on the shot clock. Haley Nichols over to Andy Flackguard along that far side. Down low to Elise Hughes. She picks up the double team. Haley Nichols thought about the three with eight on the shot clock. Elena Taylor will take the three, and you betcha. That's her third three of the night, and the Chargers back on top by three, 40-37. In fact, UAH has eight threes on the evening, and Flackard comes away with the steal, able to get the basketball. Does not have numbers, kicks it over to Krieger. Krieger off the glass, good. Maddie Krieger gives the Chargers a five-point lead here in the third with 3:50 to go, 42-37. So five straight points by the Chargers on a 5-0 run. Down low to Grace Owen, kicks it out. Delta State gives it back down low to Cameron Davis, and Davis the spin move. That's Cameron Davis's second field goal. She has four on the night. Chargers, though, still lead by three. Elise Hughes drives, spins, has the ball taken away by Grace Watson. Watson, Delta State, kicking it up into the front court. Michelle Smith drives on Andy Flackard, and Michelle Smith going to get called for the travel. So that's the 11th turnover for Delta State, and we've got our first media timeout of the second half. So with 3:12 left to go in the third, it's UAH 42, Delta State 39.
What's better than Valley Equipment Rental? Two Valley Equipment Rentals, and that's just what we have now. The original on the South Memorial Parkway between Drake and Airport Road, and their second location on North Memorial Parkway, just north of Winchester Road. Valley Equipment is locally owned and has more skid steers, excavators, and lifts than anyone in the area, plus all the small tools that you need to get the job done like a pro. And if you are a pro, you need to check out the new North location now, because Valley Equipment has what you need. Learn more at valleyequipmentrents.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
All right, welcome back to Spraggins Hall on the campus of UAH. We've got UAH women's basketball taking center stage tonight. And right now, with 3:12 left to go in the third, it is the UAH Chargers holding on to a 42-39 lead over Delta State. So the Chargers so far in the third, shooting 3 of 11 from the floor, 27%. By far their lowest shooting percentage of the night. Chargers shot 46% from the floor in the first, 50% in the second, and in the third, shooting just 27%. Delta State shooting 48% for the game right now, 17 of 35. But the good news is the Chargers have the lead, 42-39, with 3 minutes left to go in the third. Andy Flackard drives, kicks it out to Krieger on the right side. Krieger spins down into the baseline, gives it back over to Flackard. 10 on the shot clock. Olivia Howard gives it over to Taylor, and she has her three blocked, but we've got an illegal screen, I believe, on Olivia Howard. Actually, the foul is going to be on number one, Olivia Howard. That is her first, team's first. So that gives the ball back over to Delta State, and the Statesmen have a chance to tie with the triple. And Alana Smith gives it down low over to Watson for the jumper. No good off the mark, and Olivia Howard comes away with the rebound. Chargers pushing the tempo. That's going to be Taylor Maxfield into the game for the first time. Gives it over to Andy Flackard. Hands it over to Maxfield. Crosses the court back over to Elena Taylor. Taylor trying to find Olivia Howard down low. She does. Howard goes to work and has the shot blocked. Here comes Delta State pushing the pace. The spin into the baseline from Mackenzie Hill is good. So Mackenzie Hill's first field goal of the night makes it a 42-41 Chargers lead with 1:55 left to go in the third. That's going to be Olivia Howard driving, and she gets called for the travel. So that is turnover number 14 for the Chargers. Delta State now with the basketball and a chance to take the lead back here in the third. Chargers had the lead the entire first half. Delta State had a lead briefly here in the third. They have a chance to take it again here. Grace Watson got the ball down low, and Olivia Howard, I believe, going to pick up the foul. It is. That is Howard's second team foul for UAH number two here in the third. So Delta State to inbound it underneath their own basket. Gives it over to Grace Watson. Watson gives it back over to Michelle Smith. Smith down low to Watson. A little two-man game, and Grace Watson is fouled, this time by Andy Flackguard.
Foul number 15, Andy Flackguard.
That is her first foul, third team foul for UAH. That is going to send the Hazel Green native Grace Watson to the free throw line. Watson, just a 59% free throw shooter, misses her first. She has one more to go, this for the tie. And it is good. So Grace Watson's first free throw of the night gives us a tie of 42 all with 1:25 left to go in the third. Andy Flackguard now facing a 2-3 zone from Delta State. Over to Olivia Howard. Chargers with 15 on the shot clock, trying to find something offensively in this zone, but having a hard time. There's the give and go from Olivia Howard to Elena Taylor. That's how you break the zone. And the Chargers on top, 44-42. Under a minute left to go in the third. Delta State, that's going to be Mackenzie Hill. Now the Chargers settle into a 2-3 zone themselves. A little matchup 2-3 zone. On the left-hand side, Michelle Smith drives, gives it over to Watson. Watson kicks it out. The three ball is no good. And the rebound by Elena Taylor. Taylor gives it over to Krieger. Krieger back over to Flackguard. And Flackguard calms it down. 20 on the shot clock. Over to Maxfield. Gives it over to Taylor. Down low to Olivia Howard. Howard goes to work, kicks it out for the three from Flackguard off the mark. And Grace Watson comes away with the rebound. And Watson going to get fouled on the rebound. That foul going to be on Taylor Maxfield. That is her first, the fourth team foul for UAH. So under 10 seconds left. Chargers up two, 44-42 in the third. Delta State holding for the last shot. Two on the game clock. One, a little jumper, no good from Alana Smith. And so we will head to the fourth with the Chargers leading 44-42.
SportsBet is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Welcome back to Spraggins Hall on the campus of UAH. It is the UAH Chargers women's basketball on the court right now. And the women enjoying a 44-42 lead here on a Thursday night. Don't forget, coming up after this one, we will have the UAH men taking on Delta State. Now, once you get underway around 7:30 over the airways of 97.7 ESPN The Zone. Right now, you're listening to UAH women's basketball on 97.7 ESPN The Zone 3. 10 minutes on the clock, our final quarter of the night. Chargers lead 44-42. 42, and it is UAH basketball to start the fourth. Elena Taylor going to drive the right side, drives baseline, does Taylor off the glass, and good! Elena Taylor found a seam along the baseline, goes off the glass for two, and she will head to the free throw line. Alana Smith picks up the foul, her second, team's first of the fourth. So Taylor, an 85% free throw shooter, gets it to go. And how about a night for Elena Taylor, 9, 10, 12. She's got 16, I believe, on the night. That's Elena Taylor. So the Chargers enjoying a five-point lead. Little drive, little jumper off the mark there. Oh, Watson with the rebound, no good. So Delta State, two good looks. They can't get it to go. The Chargers can increase the lead. They've led by as many as nine as UAH. That was coming after the end of the first quarter. Maddie Krieger drives baseline. Kicks it out. The little scoop from Andy Flackard is no good. But Flackard will head to the free throw line. And Alana Smith picks up her second foul in a matter of 35 seconds. Her third personal, second team foul for Delta State here in the fourth. That sends Andy Flackard to the free throw line, where she is a 70% free throw shooter, but she misses the first. Second one is up and good for Flackard. So Flackard has six on the night. The Chargers lead by six, 48-42 with 9:05 left to go in the fourth. Michelle Smith across the timeline for Delta State. Gives it over to Cameron Davis. Ball rolling around on the floor. Still rolling around on the floor. Still rolling around on the floor. I think everybody has touched the basketball at least once. UAH comes away with it. Elena Taylor now with possession. And Andy Flackard wisely slows things down for the Chargers. Delta State now in a man-to-man defense. Krieger drinks it out to Adel. Adel for three off the mark. Ball being saved by UAH. Ball did not hit the rim, so nine on the shot clock. Five on the shot clock. Andy Flackard's got to make something happen. She drives, and she does! Andy Flackard drives to the rim, and good things happen for UAH. Now up 50-42 with 8:05 left to go. Chargers looking to make it a season sweep over Delta State. Got a win back on December 9th, 54-47 on the road. Grace Watson, a little dump pass into the lane. A little spin around is good. Cameron Davis, her third field goal of the night. She has six, and that cuts the lead down to six, 50-44. Elena Taylor over to Haley Nichols. Nichols for three, rolls in and no good. That one rattled almost down, but I believe they're going to get Maddie Krieger for over the back, and they do. Her second personal, first team foul for UAH here in the first. So you're five on the floor for the Chargers. Maddie Krieger, Andy Flackard, Bella Matchin. You got an Eme Adel and Haley Nichols, the five on the floor for UAH as they come into a man-to-man defense. Cameron Davis into the lane, kicks it out to Watson for the long two, no good. The fight for the rebound goes over to Andy Flackard. Flackard across the timeline does not have numbers, and she pulls up. Directs the offense from the top of the key. Gives it over to Haley Nichols. Back over to Flackard. Into the corner for Krieger. Back over to Nichols. 10 on the shot clock. Chargers need to make something happen. Down low to Adel. Adel, the little give and go. Out to Flackard for three. Andy Flackard, you betcha! Calls banked as Andy Flackard, and it is open. Chargers now up 9, 53-44, equaling their largest lead of the game. 6:25 left to go. Michelle Smith along that left side gives it over to Jenny Higginbotham. Delta State patiently with the offense. Michelle Smith gets the long two to go. Her foot on the line for Michelle Smith, her second field goal of the night. Here comes Adel, the little give and go. Oh, spin move there, no basket. That ball goes right back to Delta State. Delta State now taking their time once again. Michelle Smith gives it over to Cameron Davis. Down low to Grace Watson. Watson into the lane, which seems like an eternity. That's going to be Mackenzie Hill on the drive.
Personal on Haley Nichols, number 45.
Haley Nichols picks up her second foul. And that is going to send Mackenzie Hill to the free throw line for two. Mackenzie Hill, a 68. Mackenzie Hill, a 68% free throw shooter. First one is up and short for Mackenzie Hill. She already has one free throw on the night, does Hill. She is 1-for-3 from the line tonight. Second one is up and rolls in for Mackenzie Hill. So Mackenzie Hill has 4 points on the night. Chargers lead by 6, 53-47. They can add to it as they have the basketball with 5:33 left to go in the game. Chargers along the right-hand side. That's going to be Maddie Krieger. Gives it over to Bella Matchin. Down low to Haley Nichols. Beautiful pass. Beautiful pass from Bella Matchin to Haley Nichols. And it is a 55-47 Charger lead with 5:10 left to go. And Andy Flackard comes away with the steal, a 2-on-2 break, and cannot get it to go. Delta State with the turnover. Back comes the Statesman. Kicks it out to Burridge. Gives it back over to Smith. And Bialana Smith along the left side. They're going to find Cameron Davis down low. No good. Grace Watson fights for the rebound. Gets it. And Delta State with another possession. Alana Smith down low, and she is going to be fouled, I believe, by Haley Nichols.
Personal foul, the third on number 45, Haley.
And it is indeed on Haley Nichols. That is her third personal. That will send us to our media timeout here in the fourth. Good news, Chargers lead 55-47.
What's better than
Qualis Corporation, headquartered here in Huntsville, is a woman-owned small business providing technical services in the areas of engineering analysis, testing, and support services to both commercial and government customers. For 29 years, Qualis employees have provided award-winning support to complex technical and engineering efforts, helping ensure critical programs, products, and systems are acquired, tested, and fully operational when fielded. Qualis Corporation, proud sponsor of the UAH Chargers. Go Chargers!
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there. Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
And welcome back to Spraggins Hall on the campus of UAH. It is UAH basketball, women's basketball. Fourth quarter, 4:35 remaining in this one, and the Chargers enjoying a 55-47 lead. UAH has led for a majority of this ball game. Delta State did lead a little bit in the third and a little bit in the fourth, but the Chargers have been in control pretty much all night. Delta State with the possession, gets it down low to Kaya Toney, kicks it back out to Michelle Smith. Cross court pass to Grace Watson. The long three from Merge is off the mark, and the Chargers come away with the rebound. Bella Matchin hauls in the board. Gives it over to Andy Flackguard. Flackguard now directs traffic at the top of the key. 20 on the shot clock. Back over to Flackguard. To the far left side to Taylor Maxfield. Or Ellen Fleming, I should say. It's Ellen Fleming into the game for the first time. Kicks it over to Fleming for the long three. A hard off the iron. No good. Delta State comes away with a basketball. That is going to be the little turnaround from Michelle Smith. Her third field goal tonight makes it a 55-49 Charger lead. Now Delta State picking up a little bit of pressure. Chargers break the pressure pretty easily and get it into the front court with 17 on the shot clock. Haley Nichols now top of the key. Gives it over to Fleming. Fleming drives along that left side. The little floater, no good. And Delta State comes away with the basketball. Here come the Statesmen, trailing by six. With 3:05 left to go. Down low to Grace Watson. Watson on Haley Nichols draws a double team. Back down low to Watson, who draws another double team. That's going to be DeKaya Toney. Drives, kicks it out. The long three from Michelle Smith is off the mark. Then the Chargers grab another rebound. And head coach Andrea Lemon wants a timeout with 2:46 left to go. Chargers enjoying a 55-49 lead.
Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance, located in the Rosie's Shopping Plaza, strives to help customers find the best auto insurance, home insurance, life insurance, and more. No matter where you are in life, Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is here to help you find your best insurance and retirement needs. You can find them on the web at brianbellamyagency.com or call them at 256-539-7530. Brian Bellamy State Farm Insurance is a proud supporter of UAH Athletics and reminds everyone to go Chargers. Brian Bellamy State Farm, here to help life go right.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
And welcome back to UAH Charger basketball on 97.7 ESPN The Zone 3 and, of course, UAH YouTube channel. Scott Tyson with you here on a Thursday night. And what a night it's been for the UAH women so far. With 2:46 left to go in this ball game, Chargers enjoying a 55-49 lead so far here in the fourth. UAH has outscored Delta State 11-7. Chargers shooting 44% from the floor in this quarter. Delta State shooting 33% from the floor in the fourth. For the game, Chargers shooting 42%. That's about 4% better than their season average. They came in just shooting 38% from the floor. So the Chargers having a great night from the field. Nothing a little home cooking can't cure. Maddie Krieger flung that far left side. Gives it over to Bella Matchin with 7 on the shot clock. Bella's got to make something go. Little spin into the lane. The ball rolling around. The Chargers not going to get a shot off. That's going to be a shot clock violation. That's going to be the Chargers' 16th turnover on the night. We mentioned the Chargers shooting the ball well. How about this? 42% from behind the arc tonight. As a team, the Chargers come in just shooting 28%. So the Chargers having a great night of shooting. Now it's got to make their defense stand, and they do there. Bella Matchin comes away with the rebound. Chargers out-rebounding Delta State 30-26 right now. So doing a good job there. Bella Matchin over to Elena Taylor, over to Maddie Krieger along that far left side. 10 on the shot clock. A minute 42 left to go in the game. Maddie Krieger over to Bella Matchin in the corner for three. No good. And Delta State comes away with the basketball. Delta State. Chargers just need a couple more defensive stops. The ball's going to be a kicked basketball, and I believe that is off. Yes, that's off Alana Smith. I believe she kicked that ball. And that's going to be a Charger basketball. Now, the referees, if they want to look at it, they can. We are under 2 minutes left to go in the game, and the Charger and the referees have the ability to stop the game for whatever reason they feel necessary. They don't need a reason. They can do it whatever, but this time they need a reason to see who kicked that basketball. And from up here, it looked like Alana Smith kicked the basketball off her own foot. That should be Charger basketball here with a minute 27 left to go in the game. Andrea Lemon has Haley Nichols, Andy Flackguard, Elena Taylor, Olivia Howard, and Maddie Krieger on the floor for the moment. And Elena Taylor has 16 on the night to lead the Chargers. Maddie Krieger has 13. Andy Flackguard has 11. So those are the five on the floor for UAH. Delta State, of course, being led right now by Alana Smith, who has 12 on the night. And they are indeed going to give that basketball to UAH. That's the right call right there. So a minute 27 left to go. Chargers up 55-49. Delta State coming with a little full court pressure. And the ball is going to be tipped straight up into the air. And it should stay UAH basketball. So Delta State with a little full court pressure here trying to speed up the Chargers. They need to make something happen. Chargers just need to take care of the basketball. They do get it inbounds. And they get it inbounds to Andy Flackguard, who goes up the side and gets it into the front court before she is fouled. That is just the third team foul for Delta State here in the fourth. That's to Kaya Toney's third. So Delta State needs to commit two more fouls to send UAH to the free throw line if they want to turn this game into free throws. Maddie Krieger to inbound it on the far side, and they do. The quick foul from Michelle Smith. That is going to be her first personal fourth team foul. So the next one will send UAH to the free throw line. Delta State wants a timeout to talk it over. So with a minute 19 left to go in the ballgame, Chargers enjoying a 55-49 lead. We'll take a timeout with them.
SportsBet is the official team positions of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at SportsMedAlabama.com.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching.
Well, I want to get you back to action here with a minute 19 left to go. Chargers on the inbounds. Haley Nichols takes the inbounds pass, and that will send Haley Nichols to the free throw line. So Grace Watson picks up her first personal, but now comes free throw shooting time for the Chargers. As a team, they are a 72% free throw shooting team. Haley Nichols, an 82% free throw shooting team, and Nichols calmly drains that first one. One more for Haley Nichols. Second one is up and good. Haley Nichols made both of those look easy. She's got 15. Haley Nichols got 13 on the night. My bad. I got to do my own math. That's going to be Alana Smith for two right there. And Delta State again with the full court pressure. Chargers break it pretty easily. And Grace Watson going to commit the personal right there to send Olivia Howard to the free throw line. So Olivia Howard heads to the free throw line. Howard just a 59% free throw shooter. Chargers enjoying a 6-point lead, 57-51 with 56 ticks left. So it's going to come down to, can the Chargers make their free throws down the stretch? First one is up and good for Olivia Howard. Olivia Howard with one more. Second one is up and good as well for Olivia Howard. So the Chargers lead is 8 with 52 seconds left. Just another defensive stop here, and I think we have this one. The two is off the mark from Jenny Higginbotham, and that ball goes back over to UAH. So you can start to exhale just a little bit. Chargers on top, 59-51 with 44 seconds left. Haley Nichols takes the inbounds pass, double teamed in the corner, and Nichols is going to get fouled, and she gets up knowing that she is going to head to the free throw line, and there's a chance to give the Chargers a double digit lead, and Haley Nichols just smiling all the way down to the other end of the court. Haley Nichols already 3-for-3 for the night from the free throw line. Again, an 82% free throw shooter. First one is up and rattles out for Haley Nichols. It's all right, Haley. You got one more. One more would equal the Chargers' biggest lead of the night at 9. And no good for Haley Nichols. So the lead stays at 8, 59-51 with 35 ticks left. Delta State, the three ball, no good from Burridge. Back up and good. And we've got a timeout on the floor. Chargers lead by 6, 59-53, a 30-second timeout. So the Chargers on top of by 6, 59-53 with 30 seconds left. And what a night it's been for UAH. 1, 2, 3, 4 players in double figures for the Chargers. Chargers came in just averaging 57 points a game. So they have 59 right now. But Delta State came in only allowing 57 points a game as well. So both teams defensively doing what they do, but the Chargers doing it a little bit better. For the season, UAH came in allowing their opponent 66 points a game. So UAH holding Delta State to 13 points below the Chargers' season average. And as a team, UAH came in shooting 38% from the floor, shooting 41% tonight. Olivia Howard takes the inbounds pass, and Maddie Krieger taking it back from Olivia Howard, and it's going to be Maddie Krieger heading to the free throw line. So Maddie Krieger will head to the free throw line for the first time tonight. Maddie Krieger, an 86% free throw shooter. Her first one is up and good for Maddie Krieger, who's had a fantastic ball game. She's got 14 on the night. Make that 15 for Maddie Krieger. And the Chargers now lead by 8, 61-53 with 21 seconds left. And the little score there from Alana Smith. That gives Alana Smith 14 points on the night. Actually, 16 on the night. And they take a timeout up by 6 with 18 and a half seconds left to go.
What's better than Valley Equipment Rental? Two Valley Equipment Rentals. And that's just what we have now. The original on the South Memorial Parkway between Drake and Airport Road, and their second location on North Memorial Parkway, just north of Winchester Road. Valley Equipment is locally owned and has more skid steers, excavators, and lifts than anyone in the area, plus all the small tools that you need to get the job done like a pro. And if you are a pro, you need to check out the new North location now, because Valley Equipment has what you need. Learn more at valleyequipmentrents.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Welcome back to Spraggins Hall on the campus of UAH. It's the UAH Chargers women in action right now, taking on Delta State. 18 and a half seconds left. Chargers up 61-55. Chargers 18 seconds away from moving to 6-12 in the Gulf South Conference. Delta State would fall to 8-11 on the season. And the Chargers going to take another full timeout.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration. We show up.
This is Wes Neighbors talking to Chris Haygood of Bob Wallace Appliance. Chris, what sets you apart from other appliance dealerships?
Wes, these appliances are going into the most used room in your house, your kitchen. The way we have...
Well, welcome back to UAH Women's Basketball inside Spraggins Hall. Chargers with a win tonight would move to 6-12 on the year in Go South Conference play. Andy Flackard takes the inbounds pass. Delta State content now. Well, they let a lot of time go off before committing that foul. But it's Otashe Barrage with the foul. That is going to be her second. That is the team's seventh foul. That is going to send UAH to the free throw line again. This time, it's going to be Andy Flackard, the freshman, shooting two. That one hard off the iron. Flackard, a 70% free throw shooter, has 11 points on the night. She's now 1 of 4 from the free throw line. Gets that one to go, does Andy Flackard. So Flackard, 2 of 5 from the free throw line tonight. Chargers lead 62-55, and that is gonna do it. Chanel Kitchens gets her name into the scoring column. But with 1.5 left, Delta State, Otashe Barrage picks up her third personal with 1.5 left. And that is going to send Maddie Krieger to the free throw line. Maddie Krieger already a perfect 3 of 3 from the free throw line tonight. First one is up and good for Maddie Krieger. Krieger with 16 on the night. Second free throw is up and good for Maddie Krieger. So Krieger a perfect 5 for 5 from the free throw line. And that is gonna do it, folks. You betcha, Chargers not to win. 64-57 the final. UAH victorious in game number one here inside Spraggins Hall. Chargers get it done as they move to 6-12 in conference play. And if you look at it, you have to say,